Good morning, dear students. Welcome to another session of digital switching system. In previous class, we dealt with concept related to two-stage networks, wherein we considered m is equal to n, that is number of incoming trunks equal to number of outgoing trunks, and solved a problem related to the same. Now let us consider the other condition. That is, say for m greater than n, that is number of outgoing incoming trunks is greater than the number of outgoing trunks, so which is basically a concentrator. So in this case, so what are the parameters we have to decide in order to have an optimum solution? So that is what we have to check out. Now if I want the other parameter, that is for the expander, that is, which is m is less than n, so what I do is I make slight changes in the case 2 itself and obtain the overall results. So let us move further and see what can be observed. Now let us consider the concentrator where m is greater than n. Let m be the number of inlets for each of the primary switch, n be the number of outlets for each of the secondary switch. In previous case, since we had m is equal to n, the inlets and number of inlets and outlets turned out to be equal. But in the design stage, that when we solved the problem, we got to know that there will be slight variation based on the parameter what we choose. Now in this case, the number of primary switches which are required is given by number of incoming trunks divided by the number of inlets of each primary switch, as we had in the previous case, that is number of trunks divided by the number of inlets or the number of outlets what we had chosen. Now number of secondary switches is given by number of outgoing trunks divided by the number of outlets. Now number of cross points per primary switch is given by number of inlets for each of the primary switch is given by the product of number of inlets of each of the primary switch into number of the secondary switches. Similarly, number of cross points for this is the secondary switch is given by number of outlets of the secondary switch into number of primary switches. So this two gives me the number of cross points per primary switch and per secondary switch respectively. Now the total number of cross points is given by this equation. So what does this equation specify? M by M is the number of primary switches, and this parameter is nothing but it is related to the number of cross points per primary switch. Similarly, here we have n by n, which is the number of secondary switches, and this parameter gives me the number of cross points per secondary switch. Sorry, please make a correction over here. This is m into n by n. So it's a typo error what is there, so please make that correction. So if we adjust that parameter, we end up with this equation, that is m into n into 1 by m plus 1 by n. So this is the total number of cross points, and it is C2 since it we are in a two-stage network. Now number of links which are required is given by number of primary switches into number of secondary switches, which is m by m into n by n. So this is the number of links. Now but here one interesting parameter what we have to look out is the number of links is optimized based on whichever is the lower value, whether the number of incoming trunks is lower or whether the outgoing trunks are lower. So in this case, if we just observe, since we are considering the concentrator, n is a smaller value, therefore the number of links is restricted by the number of outgoing trunks in this case. Therefore what we have is, as m is greater than n, then the number of links is restricted to be equal to n. So when I substitute this value in this equation, we end up with this parameter. So when we solve it, what we have is, we have number of outlets equal to capital M by M. Now if I substitute in the number of cross points, that is this equation. If I substitute this parameter, that is lowercase n in this equation, we end up having this parameter, which is C2 is equal to m into n into m divided by capital M plus 1 by m. Now let us see what happens if I have to optimize the number of cross points. What should be we doing? Now in order to optimize, what we do is we differentiate this with respect to m and equate it to 0. So doing this gives me a optimum number of cross points, and it specifies what is the specific value for m in order to obtain a optimum solution for the cross points. So that is, once we do this, differentiate C2 with respect to m and equate it to 0, we end up with the specific relation, that is m is equal to square root of capital M, that is square root of number of incoming trunks. So when I substitute it in the other equation, what it turns out is, it turns out to be even the number of outlets is equivalent to square root of m. So this is based on the optimum solution. Now number of cross points are minimum when m is equal to n. So if that is the case, then what happens is, this is the overall result what I'll be getting. That is, you can see that m value is square root of m and n value is square root of m. So that is what does this equation indicate, that is number of cross points are minimum, that is we have an optimum solution when both the values are equal. So if that is the case, what are the number of cross points which are present in the optimum design? So it is given by this equation, 2 into m square root of m into n. Now one thing to observe here is, now since we are making use of m is equal to square root of m and n is equal to square root of m, this is for the optimum solution. Practically we have slight different approach when we design the entire network. Let us look forward for that in the next problem. Now when we take the square root of say the any parameter, we may end up having a fractional or a decimal term. Now what we do is, as we had done it for the previous case, we should do the same thing, that is a single stage, and the same thing has to be repeated in the two stages, that is m and n, when they are taken as square root of m, they should be considered as integers which are close to the value what you have obtained, that is square root of m, and it should be the factors of m and n respectively. M should be the factor related to m and n should be a factor related to n. Now this indicates that there is a slight modification. What we do is, in order to estimate, we make use of this kind of equation, that is n is equal to square root of n, because n is a smaller value, and m is equal to m divided by square root of n. So this is the value what we make use of. Now if I want the design, the same design for a expander, what I do is, one simple thing, we have to interchange all the parameters in this case, that is you change m to n, so this gives me n greater than m in this case, and this one you change, so where all we have these parameters are not the inlets, here we are having number of say in this case we change it by all these parameters, we change m to lowercase n and n to lowercase m, and capital values are capital terms are interchanged. So this will be giving me the design parameter for the other. And if we just look, because of the symmetric nature, all the equations will be same. In simple terms, what we can specify is, if I tell that m is the number of outgoing trunks and n is the number of incoming trunks, then the equations remain same. So that in simple form, this is the case. But when we are just representing, we may just follow the standard terms, that m represents the incoming and n represents the outgoing. Just for design point of view, we can have this interchange when we are presenting the case. So let us look at a problem based on the two-stage network. So in this case, we have to design a two-stage network to connect 12 incoming and 9 outgoing trunks. So you can see that incoming m is 12 and outgoing n is 9. So here you can see that as per our condition, we have m greater than n, which is a concentrator. So if that is the case, let us move forward and see what is the optimum solution we have to obtain. Now in order to obtain an optimum solution, we had discussed that previously m is equal to n gives us a optimum solution, and if and it is equated as square root of the incoming trunks. So in this case it is 3.47. so it is basically a square root of the higher value. If incoming is higher, it is square root of the incoming trunks. If outgoing trunks are higher, that is, for example, if outgoing trunks was 12 and incoming trunks were 9, then it would be a expander. In that case it would be square root of n. So now let us concentrate on the problem which is given here. So for optimum solution, we have m is equal to n, which is equated as square root of m, that is the square root of the higher value, so which turns out to be 3.47. Now the next step is we have to decide on the values of m. We cannot have inlets and outlets as 3.47. We have to choose an integer value which is close to 3.47 and is a factor of m and n respectively. So if we just look out over there, what happens is the two possible values, we can have two possible values, that is m equal to n is equal to 3. 3 is a factor of both, and we have 4, which is in this case we are considering it to be a factor of m. So m is equal to n, which is a factor of 3, which is a factor of m, that is 12, and 4, which is a factor of 12. Now because we are using this equation, we have to consider the factor close to m, factor of m. So when we substitute the same in the number of cross points, using say m is equal to n is equal to 3, we end up with 63 cross points. If we choose the other case, I have solved it in next this thing. Okay, so this is the optimum solution what we are trying to identify. If we consider m is equal to n is equal to 3 and we try to obtain the cross points, we have 63 cross points. Now how many number of primary switches are available? So it is given by capital M by m. M is 12 divided by 3, which is 4 number of primary switches, and the switch size turns out to be 3 by 3. We choose a standard value, which is a number of inlets. 3 is identified from this value m, which is equal to 3, and we choose a standard value which is 3 by 3, and number of secondary switches is given by capital N by lowercase n, which is 3. So that is specified here, and the switch size turns out to be 4 by 3. How this turns out is, if you just see, there are 4 number of primary switches. Therefore from each switch you'll be having one connection to the each switch of the secondary stage. So in this case what happens is I'll be having 4 links which will be connected to one of the primary switch. So each secondary switch will be having one link which will be coming from each of the primary switches. Therefore you have number of inlets for the primary switch will be 4, and we can see that since n is equal to 3, we'll be having number of outlets which is equal to 4. Therefore the switch size turns out to be 4 by 3. Now similarly, when we consider m is equal to n is equal to 4, when we substitute, we end up with the same result of the cross points, that is 63. Number of primary switches will be m divided by m, which is 3. So therefore I have 3 primary switches, and the size of this primary switch is dependent. So let us see, in order to decide this, let us see what happens in the next stage. Number of secondary switches is n by n, which is 3. Now the size of this one is again 3. Now what happens is, why this turns out to be 4, that is number of inlets, even though I have anyways it is specified here that it is 4. Therefore the number of inlets turns out to be 4, and since we have 3 switches, I cannot go for 4 by 4 directly here, because I have to wait and see what is the design value for the second stage, that is the secondary switches. So here you can see that there are 3 switches, so it indicates that the number of outlets per primary switch should be equal to 3. Now once we are done with this, we have that number of outlets, that is n is equal to 4. Because of that we have decided it as 4, therefore the switch size is 3 by 4. By doing so, what we are specifying is, if we just estimate 4 into 3, it gives me the outgoing trunks as 12. So actually we are having excess of 3 trunks in this design at the cost of reducing the number of cross points. So in this case we had one standard switch and one non-standard switch, but in this case both are non-standard switches of size 4 by 3 and 3 by 4 respectively. But practically, when I go for the design, so what is a practical design approach? Now we had in practical design approach, in order to obtain the optimum solution, we have to equate the number of primary switches into number of secondary switches equivalent to the lowest value. That is, in our case, it is the lower value is n. So when we equate at this, we end up with these two results. So when we end up with these results, and when we equate the cross points and see what is the value of n, we end up having n is equal to square root of n, which is equal to 3. Next we have we should see what is the number of inlets which are required, which is obtained by using this equation. So this turns out to be 12 by 3, that is 4. So let us see what happens if I choose number of inlets to be 4 and number of outlets to be equal to 3. Therefore number of primary switches is given by m by n, which turns out to be 3 primary switches are required. Now this 4 is taken by this value. Now number of secondary switches is n by n, which turns out to be 3 secondary switches. Whereas in this design you can see that we had 4 here and 3 here, 3 here and 3 here. So let us see what changes we observe when we go for practical approach. Now the primary switch size is given by 4 by 3 and the secondary switch is given by 3 by 3. Now how we have decided on this one is, now you can see that m value what we have estimated is 4. So that 4 is relevant to this parameter what we have chosen. And how many outlets are there? How many outlets is decided by how many number of secondary switches are there, because there will be a link going from each of the primary switch to each of the secondary switch. Therefore there will be 3 links for each of the primary switch, which will be going to each of the 3 secondary switches. Now similarly, the secondary switch, what it implies is, since we have 3 primary switches, it will have 3 inlets, because I have to receive one link from each of the primary switch, and this parameter is decided by this value, that is n is equal to square root of n. Therefore the switch size is 3 by 3, and when I estimate the cross point, this also gives me a cross point which is same as that we had obtained previously, that is 63. So this is how this is the total design what we have for the link systems in two stage networks. Now going further, as we discussed, let us discuss three stage network in just a simple form. In three stage network we have three switches which are present, which is primary switch, secondary switch and tertiary switch. Since there are three stages, we term it as three stage network. And as we had discussed, between a primary and secondary there should be a link which we identify as A links, and between a secondary and a tertiary we should have a link which is identified by the B link. So this is in general what we have. So regarding this, let us discuss in the next class. This is all for today. Thank you.